Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. Someone asked a question on a video I created a while ago. If you haven't seen that video, go check it out. It'll give you a little more context. They're asking about these text slicers. To be honest, I never used these text slicers, so you're about to see me use text slicer for the very first time. They ask, hey, I have a bank name and a routing name. When I enter the routing number, if it's an invalid routing number, say invalid. If I enter the bank name, say it's invalid. But it got a little tricky because they were like, if I choose the bank name and I enter a routing number that's not associated with that bank, say, hey, this combination is invalid. I was like, oh, this is interesting. So, you know what we like to do? Enough of all this talking. Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So let me show you how I started this up. The first thing I did was I created a model using some metrics that I'm capturing on our YouTube channel. So this is daily stats, so views, likes, and counts, and things like that. And this is the videos table that can filter this. But then on the other side, I have a channels table that can filter this table. And so consider the channel, the bank name, and the video, the routing number. So if I select the channel and the host of that video doesn't correspond to that channel, we got an invalid combination. But if I select the channel and a corresponding host, we have a valid combination. So then we'll go back to our report. And how I started this was I started by creating a measure, and we call this selected host equals. And then I created a variable because I want to do a little debugging. And so I'm going to say selected channel, not host. Sorry. We'll do host in a little bit. Channel. It's okay. Channel found. And basically, I'm just going to see if there's a filter. And you can do this lots of different ways. I chose has one filter because as of the recording of this video, you only can do a single filter on this text slicer. So in channel name, and let's do a little debugging to see if when I enter something into that channel name, if it's a valid channel, it'll return a true. If not, it'll return a false. So let me just drag this here so you can see the list of channels we have. Guy in the Cube, Fabric, Power BI. Let's go over to my selected channel, drop that there. Right now it says false because I don't have anything. But if I enter Guy, true, okay? Because that's in my list. If I enter Sam, not in my list. It's false. This is exactly what I want. Okay, great. Then what I'm going to do is go back to that measure and I'm going to add a little more logic var channel result. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to say, if the channel is found, do something. Otherwise, do something else. So if the channel is found, return the selected value. Otherwise, give me a little note that's telling me you didn't find it. Do that for me. And then I'm just going to return this. Return that. So now if we go to my card, you can see it says it's an invalid entry because I don't have anything. But if I choose Guy, it returns Guy in the Cube. If I type in Fabric, it'll return Microsoft Fabric. And all I'm going to do is the same thing for the host. And so I'm going to go over here on the videos, choose new measure, and I'm going to paste that in. Same logic. If there's a filter, if it finds it, return it. Otherwise, don't return it. Okay, I'm going to go over here to this and replace this with selected host. And right now it's invalid, but Martha is a valid host, so it returns Martha. We have our text slicers, but the second part of this, I had to really think about this because if the combination is a valid combination, return something. Otherwise, let me know that there's probably a challenge with the combination. And to do this, I had to introduce a measure. And I probably could have written some really complicated DAX or a good bit of DAX to figure it out. But introducing a measure into this made it easy. In my case, if the channel is selected and there's a corresponding host, there will be views. And so the combination of all three of those lets me know if it's a valid combination. And so I created another measure. And so basically I did the same thing. I found out if there's a filter on channel and host. And then I did a combination here. I used and I said, if both of these are true, it's gonna return true. If one of these is false, it's gonna return false. And then I said, check to see if I actually have rows in the video stats table. And so then I'd use that and logic again to say, if both of these are found and I have views, everything's found. So I have a both found and an everything found. And then in my return statement, I said, if everything's found, tell me everything's valid. Otherwise, hey, you got two valid entries, but it's not correct. And if you don't have two valid entries, then we have a different message here. So let me show you what I'm talking about. Okay, so we're gonna clear this out and we're gonna go over here and clear this out. And we're gonna take that title. I'm gonna drop that title right here. So now you can see, please ensure that the values are entered for both slices. So then I'm gonna choose Guy, right? It's a Guy, but I don't have two. And then I'm gonna put Patrick. And you can see both entries are valid, but watch this. I'm going to put fabric because fabric is a host on the fabric channel. It says you got two valid entries, but the combination isn't correct. And that's because it couldn't find any views for the combination of the two values that were entered. So in this case, guy and fabric produces nothing. But if I put guy and Patrick, they're both valid and we have values here. So now let's put all this together in a nice message. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to insert a text box. You may be thinking, Patrick, why a text box? But watch this. I love this text box because I can actually add values. So we're going to use the message title, and I'm just going to call this title save. There's the entry. And what I'm going to do is format this. And I like it because I can format this message any way I want. Both entries are valid. Okay. If I change this, it says, please ensure for both. But if I put an invalid host here, two valid entries, but the combination isn't correct. Please check this out. So let's clear everything out here. And then what I'm going to do now is I'm going to do a little this right here, and I'm going to put the host. What I'm going to do is go insert for its selected channel, and I'm going to call this one channel just in case I want to reuse it later, and click save. And then I'm going to go again, and what I'm going to do is enter selected host, and I'm going to call this one host. This text box is amazing. I like using it because I can format things better. And then I'm going to bump these up to about 16. And so you can see I have invalid entries. So I'm going to put in guy in a cube. All right. So guy in a cube is valid because you can see it there. And then I'm going to put in Martha. And so it's valid. So both entries are valid and I have values. But then I was like, well, if I enter one valid entry and I leave the other box blank, it's going to display values anyway. And I don't want to display any values until both are there. So I had to make another little tweak. So right now, if I get rid of the host, you see how it still displays values, but it's saying, hey, I got an invalid entry in the second one. So I want to stop it from displaying anything until both are valid. And so what I did was, watch this. I'm going to copy this and move this over here. And I'm going to copy this and I'm going to move this over here. Okay. And so what I did was I created another measure. And in this measure, what I did was I grabbed the selected values in those text boxes for the channel and the host. And then I wrote a measure calculate that will pass in the channel and the host as a filter. And it has to be a valid combination for it to return a value. So then I went over to the chart and I got rid of daily views and I added daily views. I think I called it with a filter. And I did the same thing here. I got rid of this and I chose daily views with a filter. And now you can see if it's just one valid text in the text slicer, it won't return anything. But if I go back and I add Adam, it returns something. I'll make sure that we put a link to this particular PBIX file in the comments below, because that's a lot to unpack in a single video. I was so excited. I saw it and I just started working on it immediately and I wanted to do a video. If you have other ways to do this, let me know. Post it in the comments below. If you want to learn more about Fabric or Power BI, probably a video flying above my head. And as always, from Martha, Adam, and this guy, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.